Laci, how are you?
I am good now. Obviously, you see I'm in a vehicle.
Yes, I see this. Now, let me lay this out for our viewers. We were supposed to do a very professional Zoom interview. I've been doing them with everybody. And then suddenly, I have the scam expert on the show. And I hear, oh, there's a problem with the Zoom. She doesn't have Wi-Fi. And the next thing I know, about half an hour later, you're in your car. This feels like a scam. This feels like a scam to me.
Honestly, it is, Conan. You know, my office is my car. This is where I do all of my business.
this is so suspicious. If I swear to God, if I didn't know any better, I would say, oh, you're somehow grifting me right now. That's what's happening.
Just a little bit. I mean, Conan, I told you could come to my office if we weren't social distancing and you'd be right here in the passenger seat. That's where I do my paperwork.
When I first heard about your podcast, I thought that you would be, I don't know, making fun of people that scam or putting them down. That is not the case. You have great respect for people who scam. You think it's an art, don't you?
I do. These are con artists. You know, I love robbery. I love fraud. I just don't want to see people get hurt. So if you're scamming the big bad guy or, you know, evil corporations, then I'm like totally on your side. But if you're hurting people, I'm not into that. Like,
so what you like, to be clear, is you like the good kind of fraud, the good kind of felony, the good kind of corrupt deception. That's the kind you like.
Yes. And believe it or not, there is a good kind. I mean, our government is running so many scams on us. What is a parking ticket? You put your car somewhere and then some hustlers from the government take it away and make you pay to get it back. It's a scam.
So you think anytime your car gets towed, you think that's a scam?
Yes, it is robbery. And I've been towed 12 times, and that is not an exaggeration.
You know what? I think there's a 50% chance you will get towed during this interview. We will see them first put a boot on your car, and then you're going to get jacked up and you're going to be taken out, right? And you're just going to keep doing the interview.
I will. The car will be moving, but I will continue to do the interview.
The car will be moving backwards, and then you'll end the interview at an impound lot. So, you know, until you brought it up, I didn't think about it, but it is a perfect scam. They put a ticket on your car because they say what? They're going to clean the street?
Mm-hmm.
And then they take the car. Then you have to go and pay to get a car that you already own back.
Yes.
So it begins with the street cleaning. You think the street cleaning's a scam?
It is. I've seen street. Okay, so I encourage people, especially in Los Angeles, during COVID, when they stopped giving tickets for street cleaning, like, look outside. Is your street much dirtier? Is it? No. I don't think so.
No.
And I've seen street cleaners give tickets after the street cleaners already passed and cleaned the street. I'm like, no, that's not right. Like,
right. They got to make that money. It's all a scam. Now, you see scams because of this is a passion of yours. You see them everywhere, right? You see scams everywhere. You see scams when you go to church, I'm told.
Yes, I go to a scam church that I love very much. Like, for example, like there definitely has been like a sermon where our pastor will come out. I will not say his name because, child, I don't want to get in trouble. But they'll come out and they'll be like, hey, hello, congregation. I need y'all to pre-order my book in his name. Amen. And, you know, I pre-order the book. I also send my tithes via text and Venmo, and they remind me. So there's, you know, there is a VIP section.
Oh, wait, you have a VIP section in your church?
Yes.
Is it much nicer? Is it like a sports box at a stadium where you get to have free hot dogs and stuff? What's so great about the VIP section?
Well, one, it's in the front and it's a pretty big church. The seats aren't quite different. They just have like a little velvet rope to keep, you know, the normie Jesus folks out. and right now I do not sit in VIP at church, but it is a goal of mine.
Okay, so basically, yeah, it doesn't feel like that's what Christ was all about, was let the people that are paying the most come to the front. That doesn't quite seem like that was the message.
You know, Jesus was turning water into wine. Some would say that's bottle service. And so...
You're right. He probably did have a bunch of scams going, now that you think about it. You know, this guy's, he was dead, but now he's alive. Lazarus. Really? Okay, we have to look into that. A lot of questions we have for Jesus. And then he skips town. He skips town, right. And we haven't seen him.